So the first prime, which is going to be the last coat actually, is finished, and you can see here the result of this clean prime from Rustoleum, how it's look, how nicely it's look. And I think it's the best primer for metal in the market now. And it's very easy to apply it. It took him like half an hour to dry. And let me show you here how it's look. So the next thing is to paint the top coat on it. Just want to show you, compare it with the other railing. This is the other railing here. You can look how rusted it is and how ugly it looks. Okay, and this with comparison to this. And remember, this one was grinded, sanded, and all the rusted was removed from him. So in this railing probably I will take different approach. Here I'm probably going to use the other method that Rustoleum offer, which is to put a rusty primer over this rusted after you actually remove the rust with the iron brush. Not sand it, actually just remove the unstable rust and apply different coat to it. So it is going to be by far easier than here, because just to remove the rust, which means to blast the rust with grinder, it took me at least 3 hours, and it's a lot of work. So I would like to see the other result with the other railing here. See what. So what I'm going to do before I'm going to apply primer here on these, I'm actually using these brush and this brush, it's steel brush, both of them, just to remove. You can see how much, a little bit like that, you can see how much rust is flying. This rust is, you have to remove and clean all the rust here from this iron. Here I'm not actually grinding it, I'm actually just removing the grass that you can remove with this brush. Okay, so let me show you here. So start here, you can see. So what I will continue doing is continue actually just brush the rust that you can remove from here, and then use a special primer that built for rust. So remember what we're doing here, we're just brushing the rust that can go out. The most of the rust will stay here, and we will cover it with a special primer. This job is by far easier than to actually using a grinder and grind and remove all the rust. And that should work for a long time. A lot of rusty, really. Accumulation for 10 years. And that's happened because the owner before did not really paint it. You have to paint every 3-4 years. Otherwise, that's what you're going to get after 10 years. I'm going to use this utility, this brush raster to work with. This is going to smooth this area a little bit before I'm going to put my prime. So after I finish sanding the railing, I'm going to water it with water, and then I'm going to use soap and water just to remove all the residue from the railing, all the residue of rusted. So you can see, this is important to remove all the dust from the railing before you're going to put the rusty primer. Here and even this sponge and this kind of sponge, just take it and just move it around. Just remove all the rusty material. You can see how dirty it is. Look, just very important to just move it around. You really need to really go over all of it. Look how dirty it is. So I'm going to continue with it and I'll show you the end result. So now what I'm doing is I'm actually moving with a wet sponge to show you how dirty it is. Look at that. I will remove all the rusted that actually loose here, and you don't see it with your eyes, but when you actually use the soap and water, they will remove them. You can see how dirty it is. Unbelievable. So now I'm washing again what left before I'm going to prime it. Remember, I have to go from all the directions, from the back direction also. So I finished actually washing it, all the remains, and I let it dry for half an hour, and then I'll start put the primer. So I'm going to use this Rustoleum Rusty Metal Primer, which you can actually put it as a primer on a rusted railing or rusted metal. Now the trick here is to remove all the loose and rusted from the metal and then to apply this primer. So you show how I did it. I'm going to apply this primer. Maybe you need 2 coats of this primer. 1 coat and then you can wait 24 hours and put another coat. And then over it you can put a top coat. Now what's nice in that one, it will stop rusting. So what happens, we will cover the rust, it will stick to the rust, and we don't let the rust to progress, which means the rust need water, and sorry, salt and other minerals to, and water to create this chemical process of rust. That will stop it for many years. So the first thing is to really mix it very well. I already mixed it, I just let you know that I mix it, and I'll show you how I'm going to mix it also in the container. So now I'm going to pour this Rustoleum primer inside this container here. Okay, I put a little bit, I think it's enough. And I'm going to mix it also and start working with it. So putting it here and just quite mixing, that's the most important. Otherwise it's going to be very tough to work with. Okay, so I'm start painting from the bottom actually. And actually it's self-leveling, so don't be afraid that it won't level itself. It's very easy actually. Because of the roughness of the surfaces here, I probably will need 2 coats. Remember, this one can only go on rusted and stained. It cannot go to on the naked metal. It won't attach to a naked metal. It actually attaches to a stained and to rusted surfaces.
by far easier to actually work with this paint than to actually go and use the grinder and then working with the clear primer. It took by far more time. This is taking like 1 hour to do. So I quite finished a little bit here. Just want to let you know that when you're painting, just make sure there is no leaking. Okay, if there is leak, just address it immediately. I finished painting with you, and I want to show you from close proximity how it looks like. Because remember, this paint is not only a prime, but also a sealer. What it does is stick to the rusted surface, and it just seals it. That water will not penetrate. Water and mineral will not penetrate, and we start the rusting process. Let me show you how it looks from close proximity. So you can see the surface here is not very smooth, but it's not a bad result at all. I really like the result, and that's the way it looks. Remember, that's only the primer. We need to give it the top color paint. That's the way it looks really after I give it the first coat of prime, and it might going to have another coat here. So that's the way it looks here from here, and the way it looks from here. And let me show you from the back how it looks. And that's the way it looks from the back. So you can see it's really interesting. Two railing, one of them it's white and the other one it's red brown, a maroony color or something. So this is the result, and what's left now is just to paint it with the top paint.